Deutschland, Deutschland, über alles, über alles in der Welt. Denn es steht zu Schutz und Tod.
Hi, I'm Lucy.
Hey, I'm Kylie.
And we're going to be telling you all about the Nazi opposition in Germany.
Question, who was exactly who opposed the Nazis?
Well, there are many different groups, and we're going to speak to some of them right now. First of all, we're going to talk to the Social Democrats. We've opposed the Nazis since Hitler became Chancellor in 1933.
We've organised many secret groups which distribute Nazi propaganda, but nothing works. We believe the Nazis are trying to destroy the Labour movement.
Now we're going to speak to a group of German youths.
Well, we don't like all the new things they teach us at school. Our friends that are Jewish, but they're just the same as all of us, isn't it? I don't want those bloody Nazis telling me what to do.
The youth seem to feel very strongly about Nazi opposition, but now we're going to talk to the churches.
At first we supported the Nazis, but they changed everything.
They changed our crosses to the swastika. They changed our Bible for Hitler's autobiography.
The Bible says to love everyone.
But Hitler's against Jews.
Now we're going to speak to the trade unionists.
In the beginning, we were a huge threat to the Nazis, as we could organise opposition and even strikes.
However, trade unions were banned at the same time as political parties.
They are creating an atmosphere of fear in our factories.
That was very interesting, but now we're going to hear from the intellectuals.
So we began to oppose the Nazis when they banned the experiments of the Weimar Republic. When we speak out, we are censored and driven underground. In fact, we are being treated so badly, some of our friends are being emigrated. For example, my good friend Albert Einstein's moved away.
Next, we're going to speak to the army. Grenade! Meltdown!
We started disliking Hitler when he made the armed forces swear an oath of allegiance to him.
He put the Nazi symbol on our uniforms!
He sacked a lot of our generals and made himself responsible for all of the decisions.
There's nothing he can do.
We also asked these groups what happened to them when the Nazis found out that they opposed them.
Did they get away with it, or were there consequences?
They banned all of our political parties.
They said if we didn't join the Hitler Youth, they would kill our families.
And our friend blood.
Innit?
We were drowning in the propaganda!
He's brainwashed everyone!
Drowning!
They just banned trade unions. I mean, how can one party have so much power?
We hate the Nazis! Man!
Well, I can see why there was so little opposition. Hitler was a crazy fool.
But when people did oppose the Nazis, they did it in a number of different ways, which ranged from private grumbling. To full-fledged riots and violence. So that's all we have to tell you today, and we hope you've learned lots more about Nazi opposition in Germany.
You know what I've learned today? Nazis are bad.
Say no to Nazis!
Deutschland, Deutschland, über alles.